Hi, welcome to this Pin Publishing Interactive video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to migrate a WordPress website from staging or development to production using the WordPress Toolkit in Plesk. Let's get started. So I'm already logged into my Plesk environment here, but before we get too deep into this tutorial here, I'm going to show you what I have already built. So let's just say that you have a website that's abc.com or whatever it is. Right now, and for the purposes of this tutorial, I'm just using a subdomain, but this can be anything. This could be domain.com, etc. So this is my production website. So this is, at the end of the day, this is where I want to send traffic to. So your top level domain would be up here. As you can see, it's just a simple default WordPress theme. In this case is the 2019 theme. And then I have a staging or a development site. So the reasons you would want a staging site is if you want to completely redesign your website, have it look completely different, try different theme, maybe you have different pages, different plugins, etc. But you don't want to do that in production just yet until you're ready to, you know, publish it and make it public. So that's why you would need a staging site, is to do all your work. When you're done with your work and you're happy with it, or get all the approvals that need to be done, then you can push it to the main site and you have a completely new website ready for public to view. So that's the reasoning behind having a staging, or it's also called a development website, and then you could take it to production. So once you're in Plesk, you'll have all the websites that you have. Currently, we have a bunch of them in here. But as you can see, I have my production.pimpuptutorials.com and my staging.pimpuptutorials.com. So what I want to do is I want to take the theme and the work that I've done on staging, and I want to publish it to production. I want it to make it live. So if you've done this in other environments, or if you've done this manually, this can be cumbersome, as there's a lot of files and databases that you have to move. It's time consuming, and if you don't do one of the steps correctly, you run the risk of, you know, really messing something up and your website not basically, you're taking the staging stuff into production, and sometimes there can be human error or things that you forget to do and things break. So with the WordPress Toolkit in Plesk, this is just a few clicks and you're done. So again, staging, and this is how it looks, and production, this is how it looks. So all you have to do in Plesk is go to staging and click copy data. And once you do that, you're going to get this menu, and says copy data from my website is what my staging site is called, and I want to go from staging to production. And if you have different WordPress instances on your setup, you'll get a list of more than one. I only have one, so I'm going to hit production. And then what I want to do is it's going to ask you what data you want to copy. I want to replace the files in the database. I want to basically, again, take what I did in my staging and move it to production. So that's fine. Now, what database tables? I want all the tables. And now here's one thing that you need to pay attention to, except, and it has these that are checked. Here, it's not going to copy post meta. It's not going to copy your post or your user meta or your users. So if you want those to move from your staging to your production, just uncheck that, and it'll essentially copy whatever you have in staging to production. Now, the reason they leave this on by default is, again, typically in staging, you're doing design work or new theme work or testing plugins, etc. So you probably don't want to override your production post. Now, one thing you can do is you can clone production before you start breaking it and creating a staging site. And then you know you have more or less the same posts and content there. But you also have the option to just migrate any new table that was created, or you can select the tables. For the purposes of this tutorial, I am just going to check all tables except these. And the other thing is, make sure you leave this create a restore point box checked, because what it does is If something goes wrong, you can hit a button and it can restore it. And as you can see back here, it's grayed out, but you can see it, it says restore. So you just hit that button and it basically rolls back the website. So again, you make your selection here, depending on your setup, and then you hit start. And when you hit start, you'll see it run through its course. And it's basically, again, it's taking whatever I did in staging, my theme, etc., all the work, into production. And it's going to migrate based on the settings that I selected. And this, for my purposes, it shouldn't take long. Again, there's nothing, not much there. For yours, this might take a little bit longer, depending on how much data needs to come over. Okay, so once that is done, it's going to tell me, hey, you know, changes were copied to production. I'm going to refresh the page. And I am going to also refresh the little card here. And the thumbnail is going to update, as you can see. And now the most important thing is, aside from the thumbnail, is going to production and reloading it. And there it is. So as you can see, my theme was migrated from my staging. So very easy to do. Again, if you've done this manually before, this saves you a lot of time, a lot of headaches. And this is available with WordPress Toolkit on Plesk. If your host doesn't have this and you're looking for a host or you'd like to use this tool, you know, contact us. We'd be happy to help. And that's it for this video, and that's it for this tutorial. Hope you learned something and if you found this beneficial. Thank you for watching, and if you want to learn more about the services and products that we provide, you can visit us at pinpublishing.com. If you're on Twitter and Facebook, you can find us there. If you're watching this on YouTube, we'd really appreciate it if you subscribe to our channel, as you would get notified when we release new videos. Thank you for watching, and until next time.